is Barbara Liss, and I sculpt concrete. I create faces for the garden that can be enjoyed anywhere. I grew up in Chicago, surrounded by buildings, and there's a lot of statues on the buildings. There's often faces carved in stone, and I always enjoyed those faces being immortalized in stone. Growing up, it was in structures all around me, but using it in the garden, I finally had my hands in it, and it became comfortable to have my hands in it and build things with it. The solid structure of concrete is appealing, where nature fades away, and so you always have your structure there, your solid elements. You know, something that never changes, once you make something in concrete, it's going to stay that way. And then you have a natural environment that just keeps changing. And bringing the two together, I think, are complementary. The ingredients are simply Portland cement and sand and colorant and a liquid mixture. You mix up a batch, so it's almost like clay. And you put it on the work surface and you start carving. I connect with my faces as they're being created. I do start with a concept. Maybe it's the eyes or an expression or a piece of clothing. There's never an end to inspiration. I look for pictures. I look on the internet. I look in magazines. I look just when you watch TV. If there is a face that speaks to me, that has an expression I want to replicate. Maybe it's in the smile. Maybe it's in the eyes. So it all starts with people, but I incorporate animal features or really overexpress different features of the human face. So the smaller faces that are complete concrete are great to use in the garden, on the ground, in rock walls, hanging on trees, hidden in the plants, so there's surprises year after year, year round. In my more artistic pieces that are not necessarily for the garden, I do like to add elements of natural fibers, feathers, alpaca hide, lamb's wool, and jewelry to add more dimension to the piece. I use dental tools. I use fine art paintbrushes. The curved blade leather knife and the curved blade X-Acto knife are the two most essential things that I use. And my fingers. I use my hands to feel the shape of the face. Every piece is individually hand sculpted. There's no molds. Because of the realistic eyes, you really could not mold that. The fun in creating is to make those individual pieces. Each piece, regardless of how small, is a separate work of art. We react to faces. We relate to them based on things that we've seen or people we've seen, places we've gone. I like to share those feelings and expressions that I see and replicate them in a medium that will always be there.